George Mining is John Prineas. John, good morning.
Hello, Andrew. I'm happy to be here.
Good to see you, John. Update this week here on progress being made at Mount Alexander. Tell us a bit more about the first seismic hole here.
Yeah, we have these wonderful new seismic targets that the seismic survey has identified. We finished drilling the first one, S1, very deep hole. Took a bit longer to drill than we had expected, but we have a result now. First box is ticked. It has intersected the fault structure that hosts these mineralizations. The actual anomaly itself didn't turn out to be massive sulfides. There is a big reflector there. We're still trying to work out exactly what it is. It could be the faulted zone. The great news is that it has actually intersected the fault structure we have predicted, and that's very, very important. The shallow nickel copper sulfides that we've discovered are all hosted in these structures. It's easy to find the shallow stuff. The EM survey from surface will help you with that. But the deeper stuff, the down dip continuity of these deposits, we just can't see from surface EM. We can't see past 300 meters. So the seismic is really, really important in telling us where these structures are, and we can start targeting prospective areas down there to find that big deposit. This is an intrusive mineral system, so typically they will have more mineralization at depth. So I think we're off to a great start, even though we didn't really hit the jackpot this time.
You're now testing target S2, are you?
Yeah, exactly. S2, it is also modelled as being consistent with massive nickel sulfides, the reflected down target down there. It's an area we haven't drilled very much in at all, so very, very keen to see what comes out there. S3, S4, S5 is also scheduled for drilling, so we'll find out a lot more about the seismic targets as we go along. We've probably been a bit spoiled with the electromagnetic surveys that we've done at the cathedrals, but we've had 100% success rate. Every EM conductor we've had has turned out to be nickel copper sulfides. That's absolutely amazing result. Normally you get a 99% failure rate. We've had 100% success rate with EM, so we've been a bit spoiled. Seismic is a brand new technique we're using to go to these deeper levels. So we just have to see how we go with these next targets.
And John, give us a quick word as far as the metallurgical program. What's the latest here?
Yeah, we definitely have a lot more strings to our bow than these seismic targets. We've got the shallow discoveries and we're trying to work out how to monetize those deposits. They're only small, but the metallurgy is very, very important. We have high-grade nickel, high-grade copper, high-grade cobalt, and high-grade PGEs. We want to make sure we get maximum value for all those elements. The metallurgical work is nearing completion. We're just waiting for the precious metals and platinum group metals work to be finished. It looks like we're going to have a very good flow sheet to produce commercial concentrates. So that's something to look forward to.
And you say you're already receiving some early approaches for offtake from Strickland's.
Yeah, exactly. I think third parties out there recognise the high grade, high tenor of our mineralisation. Can see that this kind of mineralisation can make money. So we're definitely receiving some serious inquiries. But we'll do our work first and then engage further. We still want to do a little bit more exploration and drilling around Strickland's and maybe increase the scale of resource. We think there is down dip continuity. There's two very strong conductors we haven't tested yet. They're not very big, but they could add significant tons to the overall resource that could be quite meaningful. So that's also something to look forward to.
Good to see you, John. Thanks very much.
Okay, thank you.